Now the fourth one, the fourth criteria is genre and style. In the healthcare industry, the type of letters you tend to write is formal, and in the UK it's formal, and OET examiners are asking you to write in this style, the formal writing, and using the right register. That means the level of formality and the tone for your reader, and how your grammar can help you to sound formal. That's actually quite important as well. So let's see what formal writing is. Formal writing is polite, it's respectful, and it's non-judgmental. You show this in the language you use to make requests out for the reader, and how you present information to the reader, and how you present information about the patient. For example, it's informal to say, "Thank you for having a look at Jane." You have to use words like, "Thank you for seeing Mrs. Jane Smith." Either use her full name or Mrs. Smith. It's formal to use the second name, and all whenever this is gonna be discussed in the later part as well. Zara is going to tell you how to use Miss, Mister, Mrs., etc. And this is always used with the Smith, the second name. Using the first name of the patient is quite informal and doesn't look good, especially in the writing part. "I have sent her to you because she needs some hypertensive medication." This is informal. "I'm referring her to you for your specialist advice regarding her hypertension." That's how you write it formally, using a respectful and non-judgmental, polite language. Talking about judgmental, you have to use the right tone when you are presenting patient information. You cannot use words like, "Mr. X is a heavy smoker." This is judgmental. You are saying that he's a chain smoker. You have to use facts. "Mr. X smokes 30 cigarettes a day." And then, for example, "Mrs. Y is a binge drinker," or "Mrs. Y is an alcoholic." You cannot use that type of language. It's judging your patient. "Mrs. Y avoids drinking in the week, but drinks 15 units of alcohol on an average weekend." These are facts about her. "Miss Z does not exercise enough. Miss Z admits she is only physically active once every 3 months." It's actually it's not what you said, it's how you said it. You should never sound judgmental in your letter. That's how you control your tone. Another very important tone here, important point about tone I would like to mention here is the urgency of the situation. When you are talking about a very urgent situation, for example, if you have a patient with bowel obstruction and you are sending him for an urgent assessment and emergency department, you have to sound urgent from the start as well. Like, "I need urgent assessment of this patient," or "I need urgent your specialist, urgent specialist advice," etc. Okay, so how to use proper grammar to make your letter more formal? These are the two things you have to avoid: the contractions and the abbreviations. The contractions are using the apostrophe s. "He is keen to return home." Do not use this, right? "He is keen to return home." These are very small things that can make a very big impact in your letter. Try not to use these. Actually, do not use these. "She's looking forward to holding her baby." Just write, "She is," just a complete sentence. "She is looking forward to holding her baby." Now, about the abbreviations, it's really important to take into account the reader when you are deciding when and where you should be using these abbreviations. using an IDDM, that is non-insulin dependent diabetes mellitus, is appropriate when you are talking to an endocrinologist, but not for an orthopedic surgeon. And when you are using AFib for atrial fibrillation, see that it is appropriate when talking to a cardiologist, but not for a community nurse, because globally there are more than one abbreviations for AFib. So you should always keep that in mind.